He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Today, let's work through a practice problem regarding the Bohr model. So the question asks, what is the wavelength of the photon that will cause an electron in the N equals 4 energy level of a hydrogen atom to jump to N equals 6? So we've depicted our hydrogen atom. We've got the one proton in the nucleus, and we have an electron that is currently sitting in N equals 4, and that arrow signifies that we're jumping up to N equals 6. So this has happened because that electron has absorbed a photon of a very particular energy to allow that transition, and we want to know what is the wavelength of that photon. In order to answer this, we will definitely need this equation that involves the Rydberg constant and the two energy levels. Just to be clear, you can see two different versions of this. So here is the other version. They're actually the same. The second one starts with a negative sign, but the order of NF and NI have switched. And so it is actually the same if you do the algebra. You can use either of these. Here we'll use the first one. We also need to know that E equals HV, or the energy of a photon, is equal to Planck's constant times nu, which we often just write as V, and that's equal to the frequency. And we also need to know that C equals lambda nu, or the speed of light, equals the wavelength of a photon times the frequency of the photon. So this is all the information we need. If you're not sure how to start, go back and check out my tutorial on the Bohr model. That should give you all the tips you need. And when you're ready, give this a try. So here is the equation that we need to use. This is going to tell us the change in energy of the electron. There's some transition that the electron is involved in, and so it goes from one energy level to another. It is going to experience a change in potential energy. And this is how we calculate it. So Ni is the initial energy level, and Nf is the final energy level. So we need to plug in 4 and 6, because we started at N equals 4, so that's Ni. And we ended at N equals 6, so that's NF. So we plug those in, and we're ready to do our calculation. If we go ahead and do the arithmetic very carefully, calculate what's inside the parentheses first, and put it into a calculator, we get 7.566 times 10 to the negative 20 joules. That is the change in energy of the electron due to this transition. Now that is very useful because due to conservation of energy, the change in energy of the electron is precisely equal to the energy of the photon that it absorbed. So a photon of some energy struck the electron absorbed that energy, and then jumped up to a higher energy level. So now that we know the energy of the photon, we want to get wavelength. So we know that energy equals Planck's constant times frequency. And we also know that the speed of light equals wavelength times frequency. So we want wavelength. So let's manipulate the second equation to read frequency equals speed of light over wavelength. And now we have another way to express V. Instead of V, we can write C over lambda. So let's rewrite the top equation as E equals HC over lambda. So that equation is going to be useful to us because we have energy and we have Planck's constant and the speed of light. Those are constants, and we can now solve for wavelength. So let's rearrange a little bit so that we are solving for wavelength. We can just bring wavelength up on the left and bring energy down on the right. And now we have lambda equals hc over e, or the wavelength of the photon equals Planck's constant times the speed of light divided by the energy of the photon. So we were just deriving this equation really quickly so that we're not confused about how we're using it, but that is the equation that we're going to use. So let's start plugging things in. The wavelength of the photon involved in this transition is going to be equal to Planck's constant, which is 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 joules seconds, times the speed of light, 3.00 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. divided by the energy of the photon, which is equal to the change in energy of the electron. Those values are equivalent due to conservation of energy. So joules will cancel because we have joules on top from Planck's and we have joules on the bottom from energy. Seconds will cancel because we have seconds on top from Planck times meters per second from the speed of light. So seconds will cancel. And if we plug all of this into a calculator, we get 2.626 times 10 to the negative 6 meters as the wavelength for the photon that is involved in this transition.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.